Hey, what's up? Alex here, and in the previous video we talked about various apps that you can use to automate almost everything in macOS or iPhone. Here's the somewhere link. Today's video is all about Siri shortcuts. We'll create some shortcuts using AI and you'll see why this is a game changer. Creating shortcuts has never been this easy. I also share one of my favorite shortcuts that helps combat procrastination and boost productivity. Let's get started. By the way, if you haven't subscribed yet, I'd greatly appreciate it if you did. Nothing motivates me more than seeing my subscriber count grow. Alright, let's create our first shortcut, which will do the following. It will take the text we dictate and add tasks to our reminders. So we'll use natural voice input and in the end we'll get a list of tasks we need to complete. Let's add a new shortcut and let's call it GPT to do. And let's add our first action, dictate text. If you unfold it, you can choose your native language and you can choose how you want to stop recording. I think it's good to have a stop recording on top. And let's proceed with the next action. It's gonna be ChatGPT. And to have these actions, you need to install official app from OpenAI, ChatGPT. And let's add this action. And I want to take a moment to explain the benefit of using ChatGPT in creating shortcuts and automations. Previously, to use natural voice input effectively, we had to clean the text before further processing. We had to remove all the symbols and identify tasks in our case, which was nearly impossible with the unformatted text. With ChatGPT, we can feed it raw text and ChatGPT will clean it and present it in format we request using natural language. So here's our prompt. We ask it to extract tasks from the provided text without adding any formatting, giving us each task's own new line. Let's replace dictate text, remove it, and let's replace it with a dictated text. And so let's expand this action. And here we have to choose start new chat. And here we can choose the model we want to use. And let's use the ChatGPT 4.0. It's the latest, greatest, and most powerful model we can use and most fastest. And let's uncheck this toggle so we don't want to see every time we run this shortcut interface of ChatGPT. And let's test it if it works as we want. Item number one, item number two, item number three. And as we can see, ChatGPT provides us clean output with our reminders we tell him. So let's move forward. And then we have to do some preparation of our text to proceed it to our reminders. Because ChatGPT cannot work directly with reminders, we have to do it manually, but we have to do it once and then we're not gonna touch it anymore. So let's grab text, get text from our output of the ChatGPT, and let's split this text by lines. So after do that, we will get every task's as a separate item. And then we have to do something with each item. And with each item, we want to add reminders with the name of item. We want to add new reminder. And since we want to do it with each item, we're going to choose the name with a repeat item. And let's choose where we want to save those reminders. If you unfold it, you can change the settings of your reminders as you want, but for now I think it's good to just leave it as is. And the last actions, let's just open our reminder list. Let's open our list where we added all our reminders and let's see how it works. Let's run it. Item number one, let's add item number two, and let's add item number three, and maybe let's add item number four, five, and six. Okay, let's allow it. And as you can see, you can pass to this shortcut long text, or you can dictate long text, and it will extract from this text action items you need to do. As we saw in previous example, the built-in dictation feature on iPhone doesn't always perform well. It doesn't always accurately recognize our voice, which may be due to my accent. I found a better solution, then we can use local LLMs. To do this, we can install the app called Aiko, this one. So I tried many different apps, which is using Whisper, but none of them have good shortcut actions. So when you install it first time, it's a downloading model. In my case, it's a model medium. So you can use this LLM locally on device without any connection to the internet. It's actually cool. Let's create our shortcut. And how are we gonna do that? I offer to you next scenario. So first we are going to record our audio. So to do that, we go into the record audio actions and let's add this action to our scenario. Everything is good here. And then we are going to save our recorded file to somewhere. And let's uncheck this checkbox and let's specify where we want to save this audio file. And I think we can save it in voice. You can specify any folder you want, so just to make sure it's saved in a shortcuts folder in your iCloud. Let's choose it. Recordings. And then let's create file with today's date. And to do that, we have to add actions with a date first. Let's add this date on the top of our shortcut, and then let's create our file voice underscore and we need to add date, and let's add extension M4A as an audio. Done. And then let's pass this file to our Aiko app. Here we can see we can start recording from it, but we want to transcribe audio using WhisperAI. Do that. And we can pass to it our saved file. It looks like extra step, but it's good to have copy of our recording so we not lose that data if something goes wrong. And let's unfold this transcribe action, and you can choose here your language. We can leave it empty, but it's good to just choose this language. In that case, we will get transcription probably faster. And we also can choose output, and here we can see we can have different format of our output. We can see the subtitles, CSV, JSON, and text with the timestamps, but for us, it's just a good to have just text. And let's try. Okay, and how it works. When Aiko transcribed your audio, then it put output into the clipboard. Then we can get this from clipboard. Get clipboard, and let's add it to the get text. And let's get text from input. And then we can try to read something. I don't know what to say, but let's try to dictate. Let's try to dictate something. I mean, couple seconds probably should be fine just for tests. And you can pass a really long file to this action, but if you use iPhone, it might take a little bit longer. But the cool part about that, about this app Aiko, you can use this app on your Mac. And if you're using a pretty fast Mac, it will transcribe text pretty fast and pretty accurate. Okay, and let's allow, and it's transcribing. And for now, it's using only local LLM. It's not connecting to internet. That's super cool. And let's see. Here we can see our transcription. And that's so actually cool. I like that. And then you can decide what you want to do with that text. So You can add some more actions to this scenario. So you can pass this text into the actual ChatGPT and ask it to do something, or you can, I don't know, just save this text into your notes, or you can save it to the Notion or whatever. But this pretty flexible and pretty accurate recognition just using the local LLM. That's actually cool, I like that. Next interesting shortcut, it's allow us to use AI to discover new music. For example, if you like current song and you want to find similar, you can enable radio by this song, but you also can ask ChatGPT to find similar songs and add it to your playlist. So how it works. So in the first action, we're getting current song from our Apple Music. So let's try to play something. Okay, that's fine. And then we asking ChatGPT find 10 similar songs and provide us list which we can use further for add to our playlist. See how it goes. And it's currently adding our 10 songs similar to what we're listening now to our playlist. And go to the our playlists, and here we go. And here we can see all the songs added to our playlist, so we can listen them and find something new. That's actually so cool. It's an interesting use case for AI. So the next shortcut, I couldn't say it's shortcuts, it's like a system of shortcuts and animations, will help us procrastinate less and increase our productivity. How does it work? Suppose we want to complete all tasks planned for today, and additionally we want to read it for at least an hour each day to avoid wasting time on social media. Let's say we have a list of tasks in our list we want to complete by the end of the day. Okay, and we, no matter what, we have to finish those tasks by the end of today. And let's say we open any social media apps and see there's a immediately timer starting. And since we not spent 1 hour in social media today, it will allow us to spend 1 hour in social media. But when we run out of time, when we spend more than 1 hour, or whatever time frame you allow to you to spend in social media. So let's open my initial shortcut and let's change for the test for the 10 second. And let's see, it's for reading, let's change it for 10 seconds too. So how it works, when we open social media and let's see, we spent more than we wanted to spend in social media, and it checks if we have some unfinished task in our list. And let's finish those tasks and let's open again social media and see, timer is immediately started. And since we don't spend certain amount of time for reading, we haven't read at least 1 hour today, it will open our book and we have to read that book at least 1 hour. So basically we cannot open any social media app because it's immediately gonna switch us to reading. So how does it work? First of all, we have to install this app called Timery. And I don't remember honestly if it's paid app. I installed it long time ago, but for me it doesn't appear it's paid. So we install this app, and this app allows us to create many different timers to count our time. So after we install that, we have to create two timers. It's a productivity social media and productivity reading. And then we want to start those timers when we open our social media apps. And here we go into the automation, and we create new automation, and we choose we want to run some actions when we open certain app. So when we open, here we can choose what app we want to count. So for example, it's going to be Instagram, social media, or, and then we can assign actions from Timery, start save timer. And we can choose what timer one. Since we choose productivity app, we want to start productivity social media timer. But it's already here, and we can see when I open all of those three apps, I'm gonna start this timer. And then we have to also stop those timers when we close social media apps. And we are creating another automation for application for close. If certain applications is closed, we are going to stop our timers. So let's choose timery. And let's find action to stop current timer. So this one is gonna be stop all the active timers you have. And also we want to run our logic, shortcut we created for our applications. So this one is the next one. So when we open any of three of those social media apps, in my case, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, or X now, we're going to open this shortcut. And let's see what this shortcut is doing. Let's see the logic of this shortcut. So first of all, when we run any of the three social media apps, it's checking how many time we already spend in those apps. If spent more than hour in seconds, it's 3600 seconds, we are going to check if we have unfinished tasks in our list, which we can define here. If I have some tasks, this shortcut will open those to-do tasks instead of social media app for us. If we done all the tasks there, then start checking if we spent more than 1 hour for reading. If not, it will open our book for us. If we spend more than 1 hour, it's do nothing and it's just allow us to browse social media apps, and that's it. That simple logic allow us to get things done by the end of the day, take care of our tasks, and make sure we read at least 1 hour. So enjoy and be productive. Thank you.
And that's it for now, and thanks for watching. Let me know, feel free to ask me if you have some ideas for shortcuts but you don't know how to do it, or you have an idea to want me to cover in the next video. See you soon, guys. Bye.